This is the VOA Special English Agriculture Report.
Now, just scan the text. And what is this report about? Is this education report or agriculture report? Just think about it. And now, let's begin.
There are growing concerns about food insecurity in the developing world.
What is food insecurity? Think about it.
Rising food prices, weather emergencies, and political problems are deepening the struggle of families in many countries.
What facts are deepening the struggle of families in many countries? There are three facts.
Three United Nations agencies published a report last week before Sunday's observance of World Food Day.
Who published a report last week? What is observance of World Food Day? Observance, what does that mean?
This year's State of Food Insecurity in the World Report says high prices are likely to continue. Gregory Barrow is with the World Food Program in Rome.
Now, while reading through the passage, just think about what caused high prices of food.
If you look at the places where the World Food Program works, particularly in developing countries, you see populations of people who might be spending 60, 70, 80% of their salaries on purchasing food for their families.
Yes, they are spending much percent of their salaries on purchasing food for their families. Why is it? What makes them spend their much salaries, their much portion of salaries spending on purchasing food for their families?
The report says even short-term price increases can have a long-term effect. Reducing nutritious food early in a child's life can affect mental and physical development and limit future earnings.
Okay. Reducing nutritious food early in a child's life can affect what? What does it affect to the child's life?
East Africa is suffering its worst drought in years. In Kenya, at least 3.5 million people are going hungry, mostly in the north. Yet food is going to waste in central Kenya. Now, farmers there want the government to buy their food and get it to those in need.
Yes. There are many people going hungry in Kenya, and what do farmers in Kenya want the government to do for them?
Farmers say bad roads and a lack of transportation make it difficult for them to get their produce to market.
What's the problem in Kenya? What do farmers say about? What makes it difficult for them to get their product to market?
Storage is another problem. And they complain about a big drop in food prices.
What else is the problem in making it difficult for them to get their product to market?
Nahashim Tatao farms almost 3 hectares, about a 90-minute drive from Nairobi. He says he regrets that he wastes at least 25% of his harvest while other Kenyans are hungry.
So for the government to make some arrangement, give transport, then they can buy it at a good price, then give to those people instead of Asking for food from overseas is very bad.
Economists say the imports reduce local food prices, decrease productivity, and increase dependency among the people. Mr. Gitao says if he could receive higher prices for his crops, he could feed more Kenyans.
From my farm, I would sell every season 800 bags of potatoes and perhaps 10,000 heads of cabbage. I've got some other farmers who can do even better than me.
Kinangop District Officer Panina Zombo explained why local governments have not taken action.
In our department, in most cases, we already work through reports and audits. So it depends on who will read the report. But we've not made an effort to have it like a priority that we want ABCD addressed.
Panina Zombo says her office does not get enough money from the central government to improve roads and take other steps to help farmers reach markets. And that's the VOA Special English Agriculture Report. I'm Bob Doty.
Now, fill out the blank by doing dictation. And I want to do knockingboard version. Just follow up the words and phrases and sentences. Just do the back shadowing and make your English proficiency completed. Okay, that's it, my folks. I wish you have a good luck and have a nice weekend. Bye.